guys, Card Bandit here. What I'm going to be going over today is a move called Bullet by Andrei Jikh. And this is a really great move. So those of you who were thinking that this might be about bullets, or might be about guns, just as a disclaimer, it's not. Or is it? Let's be honest, we've all been there, we've all had the Nerf obsession, or some of us have, and some of us may not have gotten over it quite yet, even though they should have. And anyway, guys, I do want to teach you this awesome move by Andre. It came out in his Genisis Volume 1 DVD / download set on 311 in 2009, I believe was the date. So, correct me if I'm wrong on that date, but that's when I believe it came out. But anyway, full credit goes to Andre for creating this move. It's not my own, but I do feel comfortable teaching this move because there's a lot of free resources out there already for how to do it. And I was also requested by a subscriber of mine to help him out with the move, so I'm going to give you my own viewpoints on it and my own tutorial on how to do the move. And hopefully if you haven't learned it, it'll help you learn it, and you might be able to get the move a little bit smoother given some of the tips I'm going to give you. So hopefully, guys, you'll find this video useful, and let's get into it. Alright, guys, so for this tutorial, I'm going to be doing it from the front, just because it's going to be a little bit easier for me to show you what's going on underneath the deck and what's happening with these fingers in the tutorial. So, let's get straight into the move. What you're going to be doing is starting off in mechanics grip, like so, and holding the deck fairly tight. You don't want to lose grip, because what you're going to be doing next is dragging the top card forward using the index finger. If you have too loose a grip, you're going to be dragging more cards and it's going to bevel the deck, and it's going to be hard to get that single card to come off. So you hold the deck fairly tightly to begin with, and then you're going to drag off one card. You'll notice that it's only a slight amount that you need to drag the card forward using the index finger. Now from this point, what you're going to be doing is pulling down with the index finger. Like so. Now what that does is it gets the card to move along the short edge here, and you're going to slide it along that short edge and underneath the deck. So how it slides underneath the deck is you're actually going to have to move the middle finger out to allow the card to get flush with the bottom of the deck, like so. And then you move your middle finger back to the side. So once you have the card in this position, what you're going to be doing next is rotating the card using the index finger. So the index finger, which is curled in, then sort of extends out a little bit, rotating the card around the middle finger. Once that card has reached a 90 degree, almost sort of like angle, you're going to extend both your middle finger and your index finger and pinch and press the card against the middle finger using your index finger. Like so. So the card is now pinched via the index finger and the middle finger along this edge. At this point, the index finger, so this one over here, is actually going to shift on top of the middle finger. And this sort of gives the card a little bit of a twisting motion. And without the card, it looks like this. What happens at this point is your index finger and your middle finger curl in and bring the card on top of the deck. So this finger curls over top of the deck. Your thumb, which is on the other side of the deck, grabs that card. Your index finger can then extend out, allowing the card to drop fully on top of the deck. At this point, your thumb is going to drag the card to the side. So you let go with your middle finger as well, and the thumb drags the card to the side. You bring your middle finger back to this side of the deck and pull down with these three fingers. This will actually tilt the deck upward and allow you to drag the card fully underneath using the thumb. At this point, you just adjust the card into a deeper grip underneath and you can square up. So that's pretty much your motions, and done slowly it looks like this. Alright guys, so once you've got the motions down, you've got to work on making the move look smoother. So you'll notice that if I'm doing the motions, like so, the move doesn't look necessarily as flashy, and it doesn't look as smooth. So how you make it smooth is actually you have a wrist motion that you include when you're doing the flip over the middle finger. So you still do everything else up to this point the same, but when you're rotating the card over and extending your fingers, you turn over your wrist, which gives the card a little bit more motion, and then you do the overhead, like you bring the index finger over top at this point. So that's your timing. So once you're rotating the card over, you start turning your wrist, you extend the fingers out, you bring the index finger over top of the middle finger, and that gives you a lot more motion out of the move, because you've got that additional motion of the wrist as you're turning the card over. When you're bringing the card back on top of the deck, you turn your wrist, and that gives you more motion as well. So you're going to bring the card back on top of the deck like you would normally, but as you're doing that, you turn your wrist back so that the hand is face up. And then everything else continues as normal. So at full speed, the move looks like that. So if you're actually having trouble pulling the card forward, and you might find you're having multiple cards fall out, and your cards are going every which way. So instead of doing that, if you're having trouble just doing the whole dragging motion with the index finger, or like pulling the card forward with the index finger, what you can do is actually shift the card forward a little bit with the thumb. Now this will allow you to pretty much do the dragging motion underneath with the index finger right away. The only thing I would caution with when doing the push up with the thumb is if you push the card too far forward, you're going to have trouble making the flourish smooth, because the index finger will have a harder time gripping the card, and you might drag the card too far underneath and have a difficulty clearing it as well. So you only want to push the card slightly forward with the thumb and then do the move as regular. So another tip to make it smooth is you want to hold the card loosely. You don't want to be having a death grip on the card, because otherwise it'll look very robotic. What you want is a loose grip. Not that loose, but you do want a loose grip on the card, because if you have a loose grip, you'll have more fluid motion with your fingers. And it's one card. You don't need to hold it tightly. You just need to hold it tightly enough that the card stays in your hand. Alright guys, and that was Bullet by Andrei Jikh. I really hope you enjoyed it, and I really hope you like the flourish and maybe learn some things to help you do it smoother if you already know it. Alright guys, thanks, and I'll catch you later. That's actually a really bad idea. Don't want to break the camera. Put it down. And I'll catch you later, guys.